Mr. Reardon, an honor to meet you.
Don't you have a home?
Sir?
We've been camped out in my boardroom rent-free.
Please understand that it's my job.
It's the job you chose. I've just never met a looter with your kind of dedication and endurance.
I'm not a looter.
No? So you're not here to take something from me you didn't earn yourself?
You can't just reject a government order for your materials.
Why can't I?
Well, it's an essential needs project.
Essential to whom?
It's very important. It's for the State Science Institute.
Well, the State Science Institute declared Reardon Metal unfit. They did so very publicly, nearly ruined my company. So tell me, why does the SSI now need 10,000 tons of my dangerous inferior metal?
You laid 100 miles of track along the John Galt line that proved them wrong.
You still haven't answered my question. Why? To what purpose?
Rest assured, Mr. Reardon, it's in the public interest.
I'll rest on this. You tell your people that I will not sell any Reardon metal to the State Science Institute at any time, for any price, for any purpose whatsoever.
Mr. Reardon, no one has ever refused to sell a strategic material to the government. It's against the fair share law. You have to sell it to them.
I'll make it simple for you. Tell them I won't accept payment. Now, they're welcome to come down here with their trucks and their guns and seize as much metal as they want.
That would be theft.
Damn, son. You're brighter than you look. One of these days, you're going to have to decide which side you're on.
You know, Mr. Reardon, times have changed. And we all have to be flexible. We can't be tied down by rigid principles.
Try pouring a ton of steel without rigid principles.